I welcome you to our daily Bible study. I am your host, Dr. Derek A. Reeves, and let's dive right into our lesson for today. We are still on the 21st series, Discovering Yourself, and today's lesson is going to be entitled, All That Is in the World. Let's go straight to our scripture, 1 John 2:16. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. If you notice, I did not read for all that is in the world. I said for all that in the world, or all that is in the world, the scripture speaks to us, and as John writes, and he vehemently speaks that in the world, there is only the lust of the eye. And here this term for lust of the eye is the word epithumia. Epithumia then is the earnest desire. It's an irregular or violent desire. And basically, epithumia deals with that which is illegal or should not be attained to. And so he says, the lust of the sarx, or the epithumia ha sarx. Sarx then, again, is the humanity, the humanness of all individuals that are without the leading and guiding and the sustaining power of the Holy Spirit. And so it deals with humanity in its lowest state that seeks to fulfill and to obtain every instinctual urge that leads to self-gratification and empowerment. It's not everything that is connected to the somatological or the physiological pleasures. Some things have to do with the mensiological or the pleasures of the mind, pleasures of the heart, and so forth. And so he said, there are three things that are in the world. And he says, the lust of the eye, and then he goes on to the lust of the flesh. Again, epithumia, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the ophthalmos. Ophthalmos then deals with the envious eye, or an eye that is seeking to gain because someone else has. It deals with the eye that is literally or figuratively, by implication, vision. Figuratively, it means envy from the jealous side or glance, eyesight. Metaphorically, the eyes of the mind, the faculty of knowing. And so ophthalmos then, the epithumia ophthalmos, is where the mind then is seeking to obtain, to understand, or its understanding is based upon acquiring something. Acquiring something because you are jealous, or you're trying to, the proverbial, keep up with the Joneses. You are comparing yourself with someone else, and so you seek to have more because you want to appear like you're more successful than someone else. And then he says, or the pride of life. Here the term pride is the word alizonia. And it means arrogance of life, presumptuousness of life, that you are deserving, that you're going to be better, that you are large and in charge. It is the braggadocio, or boasting, having so much consciousness or confidence that you don't feel you need God. You feel that you are the cause of all of your success. You are the thing that's making things happen. And in a way, we are, because even if God opens the door, we still must walk through it. But never forget that it is God who opens the door. It is God that brings about the clarity and the opportunities. And so it's empty bragging or braggart talking, and insolence and empty assurance, which trusts in its own power and resources and shamefully despises and violates divine laws and human rights. And so when it speaks of, again, the pride of life, Elizonia of life, an impious and empty presumption which trusts in the stability of only earthly things. And so when we speak of the pride of life, here the term life is the word bios. And it's very interesting because we now discover that the term bios or biotic life, it has more than just one standard meaning. In most cases, we take bios to mean biological life, but it means life or the means of living, the sustenance that maintains you both essentially and in the process of your modus vivendi, how you are living life, how you are making your life. It can deal with the substance and your goods. And so bios then is a primary word for life that deals with the present state of existence as it deals with modus vivendi. By implication, the term means livelihood. How do you live? How do you make your living? How do you sustain your living? And so it's life extensively, the period or the course of life, which deals with the time period in which you have to live. It can deal with the accomplishments of your goods, your successes, and everything that you amass. And so John tells us that in the world, for all that is in the world, indicating that everything that the system has, it will accommodate the lust of the flesh, the illegal desires, or those things that fulfill our primal urges and instincts. Number two, the lust of the eyes. We gain an understanding, and what we see is filled with jealousy because we're trying to impress others and sometimes trying to even impress ourselves. And then finally, the alizonia bios, the manner in which you live, in the duration in which you are, how and why you pursue the amassing of things. And so he indicates then that these three things are of the world, but they're not of the Father. And when he speaks of the world, he speaks of the word cosmos. And cosmos then can deal with the order, the regular disposition, the ornamentation or the embellishment. And so it's dealing with the system and how the system is arranged. And this is the reason why you can never seek to find or discover yourself through worldly means, because everything within the worldly system is set up to establish us to desire to find things that bring us pleasure. They are set up and established to bring to us self-fulfillment without God. It is set up that we might be successful in our pursuits that may or may not even include the desires of God for our lives. And in some cases, if we do try to pursue those things that are set in foundation for us to pursue as prescribed according to God's purpose for our life, there is a conflict and we have to choose what we're going to give more time and what we're going to devote more time to. And so the world is filled with, again, that which stimulates the physiology, that which stimulates you and causes you to pursue the instinctual urges that bring pleasure. And so the pleasure principle is more important in the world than the God principle. Secondarily, the lust of the eyes, your understanding what you see, you're consistently trying to gain things out of life that others are gaining, because you secretly feel that in serving God, you're missing something and that they have a leg up on you. They seem to be doing better. And so you secretly want what they have, and sometimes it's not even a secret. You definitely desire what they have. And then the pride of life, the alazonia bios. You want to be successful in this world more than you want to be successful in the kingdom. You desire that you might brag, even if it's to yourself, of your accomplishments, of your successes. And if you look at those successes, then the question is, how will this benefit the kingdom of God as God has prescribed for you to do? And so we have to seek a balance. And that's why you can only truly find yourself through God. There has to be a conversation with God, and there has to be some type of information that you gain from God so you can fully understand what is his expectations for you. What is his expectation for your life, for your involvement, for your achievements? And so we're out of time. I thank you for joining us. I am your host, Dr. Derek A. Reeves, and until next time, God bless and keep you.